I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
King's in the house, Mr. Vladimir Klitschko. Yes. Future Hall of Famer. And also, first time in the history of the organization, we are naming our first Ukrainian as Fighter of the Year. He is not here yet. He's coming, right? Yes. All right, he's on his way. That's a good thing. So, thanks again, everyone. I want to extend my thanks to ESPN, Top Rank, Showtime, HBO, the Copacabana, and turn things over again to our esteemed MC, Mr. Brian Kenny. So thanks again, everyone. Thank you.
It's been a tremendous year for boxing already, and I've got to, even just being able to speak to a few people over the television networks, what excitement we've seen already this year. This weekend it will be tremendous as well, as Vasily Lomachenko is fighting at the Garden, taking on Jorge Linares. Saddam Ali, Liam Smith up in Verona, New York, and upstate. So another great weekend of boxing this weekend, and it's good to see so many people still able to make it here, especially if Vasily is able to make it. It's the night before the fight, so we understand. Let's also give a round of applause to the person who is responsible for the beautiful program that you see right there at your table, Ricardo Salazar. Ricardo? Thank you, Ricardo. All right, time now. We have five nominees for Fight of the Year. Here is fight number one. This is David Benavides and Ronald Gavril, who fought it out over 12 rounds in September. There we go. Benavides would come up from a 12th round knockdown to earn a decision win in what was one of the very best fights of the year. The first nominee for Fight of the Year, again, David Benavides and Ronald Gavril. We'll show you all five, and the winner for Fight of the Year we will have for you later tonight. First, though, Nat Fleischer was the founder of The Ring magazine, so it's only fit that an award for consistently great boxing writing be named after him. And tonight's honoree is Mike Rosenthal, who is the he is the 45th recipient of the award. Mike covered boxing for 10 years for the Los Angeles Daily News and was the editor-in-chief of The Ring magazine for 6 years. Presenting Mike tonight is Muhammad Ali biographer Tom Hauser.
BWAA is a writers' organization, and from that perspective, no honor is more important to our mission than the Nat Fleischer Award for Career Excellence in Boxing Journalism. You can't win it for one night's work, for 1 year's work. The award is what it says it is, for career excellence. Michael Rosenthal could easily be honored with the WAA's Good Guy Award. If we had an award for excellence in editing, he could win it for the years he spent as editor of The Ring. Tonight, it's a pleasure to present him with the Nat Fleischer Award for Career Excellence in Boxing Journalism. Mike?
You're a fighter and you're going to be taking drug tests. For God's sake, choose the chicken or the fish and not the beef. only a joke. My only joke. Joe gave me 2 minutes, so this is going to be quick. The theme of my very short speech is gratitude. I covered boxing for the LA Daily News and then the ring over a span of like three decades, believe it or not. That allowed me to sit ringside for most of the biggest fights in the U.S. and beyond and spend some time with some of the most entertaining people I've ever met in my life. I was hired by the ring in 2008, which was exciting but also came with new challenges, which is no secret, everybody knows that. The built-in conflict of interest of a promoter owning a news outlet hung over my head like the sword of Damocles the entire time I was there. You know, even though Doug Fisher and I were committed to remaining unbiased, and I think we were, in fact, I know we were, from day one, our critics, including some of our colleagues, used the conflict every chance they got to discredit us. It bothered me at first because my integrity had never been questioned during my newspaper career like that. But I quickly developed a thick skin, which is necessary, and learned not to read or listen to what others had to say unless it was constructive. I knew I was true to my standards, the standards of my newspaper days, which means honest, fair coverage. In the end, that's all that really mattered to me. I bring this up because I hope it can be a lesson for others. If I were to advise a young writer, I would suggest that he or she do what I always tried to do. So be true to yourself and your reader, not to anybody else. That comes with responsibilities, though. Work hard, strive to maintain high standards, emulate the best writers, guys like Mark Kriegel. Always try to improve, relish the opportunity to ruffle the feathers of powerful people in the name of truth. Believe me, I pissed off the people at Golden Boy more than once with the things I didn't write. Ignore the trolls who try to build themselves up by tearing you down. And most important, be grateful, which brings me back to my premise. I was always able to overcome all the inevitable BS that I experienced and the BS in this sport, you know, we're all aware of it, by telling myself, man, you're lucky to be doing what you're doing. I always felt that way. I think we should all be grateful. Finally, I'd like to thank just a few people really quickly, my editors at the Daily News who allowed me to do this, particularly the great Mike Anastasi, Richard Schaefer and Dave Morgan for hiring me at the ring at the lowest point in my newspaper career, Oscar De La Hoya, who almost always was good to me, my colleagues, who I admire and cherish as friends, the trainers, who I think are the straightest shooters in the sport, I just love them to death, and finally the fighters, who risk their lives in part to entertain us, you know, night after night. They deserve more respect than we could possibly give them. Thank you very much for this honor.
Mike, congratulations. Ignore the trolls. There's good advice. We all do that. We know this can be a rough sport. It has its barnstorming aspect to it, but we also know as we get to greet, you know, old friends and people from across the aisle and people that you may used to have worked with and you're working with again, we know there's plenty of good people in this business and people that make it as exhilarating as it is. So it's time now for the nominees for the Marvin Cohn Good Guy Award.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.